Hey everybody, how you doing? Joe Pratap here, and we're talking to you today about how to appeal your property tax assessment if you think that the numbers are off. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is you're gonna head to the BC assessment website, which is you can find it on your notice of assessment, or you can just Google BC assessment and pull up their website. Okay. Second thing you're gonna do is you wanna make sure that you know what you're talking about, okay? So if you think your property assessment is overvalued, that's who you want to appeal. That's when you want to appeal. You can contact your local real estate agent. If you live in the Lower Mainland, you can reach out to me and I'll do my best to help you find out if that is correct. And if it is off by more than 5%, I definitely suggest that you appeal the notice. You'll save some money on your property taxes. And I'm gonna teach you what to do, how to appeal right now. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is head to BC Assessment's website. Okay. All right, so here I'm on the BC Assessment website. It's actually pretty difficult to actually find this link where the appeals area is, but I'm going to post this link right below so that you can actually just copy and paste it to make it really easy. So when you're on that, it's going to say here, a little bit about what you need to do. Okay, so the very first step of appealing your assessment is you're going to call and contact them. So they're saying that many of the matters can actually be resolved by the phone. Whether that's true or not, I'm not too sure. I haven't had success with that process myself, but that is the very first step. So what you're going to want to do is when you contact your agent, ask them to supply you with the three most recent sales comparables. Okay, so the three most recent sales comparables to your property showing that the value is overvalued. Okay. So if you have those three comparables, get the MLS numbers ready so that you know what you're talking about, so that you can say, look, I've got the three most recent sales comparables to my property. The MLS numbers are this, this, and this. And the PID numbers of those properties which are on the MLS are this, this, and this. They'll know exactly what you're talking about when you give them that information, okay? So that's the very first step. If they don't agree with you, you're actually gonna fill out a notice of a complaint appeals form, which is right here. You're gonna click it and you're gonna fill this out, okay? So it's got all the information, your name, email, your contact info, if you're the owner of the property. It's got the information about your tax assessment role here, which you're gonna fill out, okay? Legal description. And the reason that you're appealing in here, the value is too high, if it's too low, but I don't think anybody's appealing if it's too low to pay more money. And then on the ground, so this is where you're gonna put the information. So if you have those three MLS numbers handy that shows that it's actually worth less than what they're saying it's worth, you're gonna wanna put them in here. So pluck those MLS numbers right here when you get them. Right. And then below you're gonna explain why. So you can say attached, these three MLS numbers of similar homes that sold recently. Okay. And from my experience, that is good enough to plead the case that your property is not worth what they're saying it's worth. I've heard stories right now in areas like South Surrey, Coquitlam, and Maple Ridge, where property values are off by as much as 20%, which is a huge number. In fact, I've got somebody that just messaged me this morning and their property was valued at 1.15. And the last sale anywhere remotely close to their property was actually 905. So it's off significantly. So make sure you know your numbers before you call. When you call, give them the numbers. If it goes nowhere, fill out this appeal, okay? If the appeal doesn't actually get granted, there's actually a second appeal form that can be filled out, which is actually right on this form too as well. So check it out. I'm Joe Pratap. Hopefully you learned something, and that's how you appeal your tax assessment from BC Assessment. And I look forward to talking with you guys soon. Drop your comments or questions below.